and earth, they are both making dua. So look at the dua now. And interestingly enough, they are making dua against, not for. Normally the dua is for the benefit. La, this dua is against. طيب. I'm going to leave the point of reference, the one I'm quoting the whole hadith for till the last. But let me share with you quickly the first two. But this is not the order of the hadith. So, the first one, here is the syntax of the dua. خَابَ وَخَسِرْ. In another wording, رَغِمَ أَنْفُ امْرِئٍ may he lose. May he become a loser. May he stains his nose in the dirt out of regretfulness for losing. All of these ways to translate the Arabic words. خاب وخسر. شوف. من أدرك أبواه أو أحدهما ولم يدخله الجنة. That you come to this world and you find both of your parents or one of them alive and they do not become the means for you to earn Jannah. That you do not لا تسدي لهم برا. That you do not show dutifulness, kindness towards your parents, that they would become the means for you to enter Jannah. This is one. The second one, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'm going to do it myself. من ذكرت عنده ولم يصلي علي. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The one my name is mentioned in front of, or I'm being referenced to in front of, and he doesn't say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And number three, which is mawdi' al-shahid, the point of reference to my short talk, which من أدرك رمضان ولم يغفر له. That someone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, prolongs his life to live until Ramadan, and he comes out of Ramadan unforgiven. Why, ya ikhwa, let's reflect upon this for a minute. Why this? Because simply in Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a month. He sets the stage for you where you're enabled to earn that forgiveness. Normally, in a normal course of action throughout the year, we go and we do bad things and we come back and we say shaytan. Shayateen, shaytan, shayateen, shaytan, shayateen, shaytan, shayateen. What happened to the shayateen in Ramadan? They are chained. Suffidat. Again, Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani mentioned 12 explanations of the chain. What does it mean? The least, imagine this, your enemy fighting you while he's shackled. What impact will he have on you? He could do this, he could try to harm you, but the least. Imagine the masajid in Ramadan, the number of people you don't even see throughout the year in the masjid. To the extent that we came up with this, you know, title for them, Ramadani what? We say that he's a Ramadani what? Ramadani Muslim. Like we have a Eid Muslim, we have a Ramadani Muslim. And we have a Muslim Muslim. We actually came up with a title for them. But ya ikhwa, wallahi, a piece of advice. Wallahi, these brothers, attract them to the masjid. Don't show them the face. Oh, this brother doesn't pray. It just comes from Ramadan. Show him attraction. Be nice. Be kind. Maybe that Ramadan will be the turning point that he's going to be consistent in the masajid. Welcome them, يعني. Because normally the brothers and the sisters who are regular in the masjid, normally when they see new faces, that's not from our what? Our gang, you know, it's like we have that gang here. It's like he doesn't be, he's not a friend of us. He's, so show him the face. لا يعني, welcome them, يعني. That's. Imagine this, the number of people come in Ramadan. Add to this, look at these golden, I call them opportunities. Three golden opportunities in the month of Ramadan. Number one, من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Two, من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Three, من قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. What else do you want? You probably heard this before. You know what that means, right? Just fasting the month of Ramadan, which is a mandatory fast, out of Iman, believing that this is a pillar of Islam, that Allah prescribed, mandated upon you. You're not fasting because everyone else is fasting, or you're not fasting in order to experience the hunger of the hungry and the thirst of the thirsty and the poverty of the poor. No, you're saying, سمعنا وأطعنا يا رب. يا رب, you said in the Quran, يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام. Oh, you believe fasting is mandated upon you. And I'm saying, سمعنا وأطعنا يا رب. I'm submitting to you, يا رب. هذا هو الإيمان. إيمانا. إيمانا. I believe in the Quran, يا رب. You commanded me, يا رب. I'm not fasting because everyone else is fasting, or I'm just afraid people are going to say he's breaking his fast. I'm saying لبيك يا رب, like I say to Hajj, لبيك اللهم لبيك. I'm responding by fasting to your command. احتسابا, I want the reward too. I want Jannah. I want Jannah. في إخوة كده حاجات في الكتب, things in the books. يقول لك إيه, the righteous people, they say, يا رب, if you know that I worship you because of your Jannah, then do not give me Jannah. Oh, يا رب, if you want me to, if you know that I'm worshiping you because I'm afraid of your fire, then put me in fire, يا رب. شوف الكلام هذا, وكلام يقول لك إيه, أنا بقى, I worship يا رب because I love you, يا رب. يا سلام, أنت أحسن من النبي حبيبي, حبيبي. أنت better than the النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Are you better than Ibrahim? احنا بنعبد الله من اجل الجنه. We want جنه يا رب. You know, a Bedouin came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. والبدو يا اخوه لهم طريقه كده, يعني البدوي ستريت فورورد, ما عنده تفاهم, يعني ما عندوش ايه, يعني ذا اتيكيتس, ما عندوش اتيكيت شويه, لدرجة أن يحكى في قصة أمير, رجل أمير, he went out to spend some nomad time. He goes out hunting, يعني. He's رجل أمير, and he took with him his helper. فهيز هيلبر prepared for him a whole sheep to eat. So he brought the food in front of him and him by himself. He said to his ghulam, I'm going to eat all of this by myself. It's a lot of food for me. Go and look for somebody to come and eat with me. Share the food with me. So he went and he looked. He's in the desert, so he's going to bring what? A Bedouin. حيلاقي مين في الصحراء غير بدوي. When the Bedouin saw the meal, delicious. I'm sure a lot of you are hungry, and I'm making you more hungry now. Delicious meal. He went into eating like crazy. فده أمير is looking at him and saying, ما لك منكب عليها كأن أمه نطحتك. And he's teasing him, why are you eating that way, that manner, as if you're venging from the sheep as if the mother of the sheep knocked you down. شوف بقى البدوي على طول الدهل. قال هي ست وما لك مشفق عليها كأن أمه أرضعتك. Why are you feeling so compassionate for the sheep as if the mother of the sheep breastfed you? على طول بدوي. فالبدوي came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and he's telling him what? يا رسول الله أو messenger of Allah إني لا أفهم دندنتك ولا دندنة معاذ. I don't understand all that stuff that you say when you make dua. You and Mu'adh keep making dua, keep making dua. He's the one, by the way, who prayed behind Mu'adh, and Mu'adh prolonged the salah. He left the salah. A very interesting story. At the end, he said, I don't understand all this dua that you and Mu'adh make. The Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, شوف يا إخوة النبي, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أخلاق خلق النبي. خلق النبي handling, addressing such psychology. Okay, what do you say in your dua? ما تقول في صلاتك؟ صلاتك يعني دعائك يعني. الصلاة لغة. ما تقول في صلاتك؟ قال أسأل الله الجنة وأستعيذ به من النار. I ask Allah to give me Jannah and protect me from hell. What did the Prophet ﷺ say to him? What did he say to him? حولها ندندن. That's all the dua that we're making. فيجي واحد مسلم الآن يقول لك إيه, أنا ما بعبدش ربنا عشان الجنة والنار. يا سلام يا أخي, ليه يا راجل؟ ليه؟ ولماذا خلق الله الجنة وما؟ فاحتسابا للأجر, when you fast you're seeking the reward of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا, just fasting with those two restrictions, بالقيود الإيمان والاحتساب, بالقيدين الإيمان والاحتساب, غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. All the previous sins are forgiven. Two, من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا. صلاة القيام يا إخوة, صلاة القيام after عشاء in رمضان in the masjid with the imam. What if you're unable because you have to work? Pray them at home. What if you miss them one night between شروق and ظهر? Make them up, but even numbers. Instead of 11, you're going to do 12. But don't waste Salatul Layl, whether on time behind the Imam, whether at home, or whether you make it up if you go through some unforeseen circumstances. But you want to qualify for this. Every night, you should pray those rak'at, at least behind the Imam. The third golden opportunity, ya ikhwa, يا أخوات, my brothers and sisters in Islam, ليلة القدر, a night which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made hidden in the last 10 nights of the month. That is why the sunnah, the seclusion, the sunnah that you do i'tikaf in the masjid in the last 10 nights of the month, seeking ليلة القدر. If you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during that night, imanan wa ihtisaba, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi. The shuf subhanallah, ya ikhwa, even living until Ramadan, automatically expiate the sins. As-salatu ila as-salah, from the salah to the salah. Wal-jumu'ah ila al-jumu'ah. Wa Ramadan إلى رمضان مكفرات. But with one condition here, that you must make tawbah from major sins. يقول لي إيه هي ال major sins؟ شوف ابن عباس giving us, we could sit here and talk about what is a major sin and what is a minor sin for a whole 2 hours, 3 hours. ابن عباس سبحان الله put our hearts to rest when he said لا صغيرة مع إصرار ولا كبيرة مع استغفار. There is no such a sin that you can describe to be major when you immediately repent from it as soon as you do it. When you say astaghfirullah, خلاص يا رب, I'm not gonna, خلاص. And a sin that you consistently or you persist on, you insist on committing even though it's a minor, The fact that you're insisting and committing it turns it from a minor into a major. ولا صغيرة. There is no such a thing that you could describe to be that's lemon, that's nothing, nothing. مع إصرار. With you insisting and being consistent in committing that sin. فأو why? Why do you waste these golden opportunities in Ramadan? Brothers and sisters in Islam, يعني, like I promised you, inshallah, I'll finish in 5 minutes, بإذن الله تعالى, and I look forward to seeing you for Fajr. I'll be here back for Fajr, inshallah. أسامة بن زيد رضي الله عنهما كما ورد في سنن النسائي والترمذي, he saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم fast a lot in Sha'ban. So he actually asked him, يا رسول الله, O Messenger of Allah, لم أرك, I have not seen you, تصوم في شهر كصيامك في شعبان. I haven't seen you fast as many days, voluntary, يعني, نافلة, صوم النافلة, as you do in the month of Sha'ban. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم answered by saying, ذاك شهر يغفل عنه كثير من الناس. بين رجب ورمضان يغفل عنه كثير من الناس. This is a month a lot of Muslims do not pay attention to its value, to its preciousness. وده صحيح. It's a very valuable month. What did the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mean by this? The scholars, they say, Sha'ban is the month when you're supposed to tune yourself for Ramadan. Actually, they extended this to Rajab. They say, Rajab شهر الغرس. Rajab is the month when you sow the seed. وشعبان شهر الري. And Sha'ban is the month when you water that seed. ورمضان شهر الحصاد. And Ramadan is the month of harvest. هو حتى في السبورت, in sport, if you play soccer or football, do you step in the field just like that? What do you do? Warm up. If you want to really find out why the masajid the first week is packed, and then it gradually what? Empty out, until the night of the 27th. He comes the night of the 27th, خلاص كده إيه؟ وتشوفوا على العيد وخلاص. لا 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 لا. شوف, من صام رمضان, من قام رمضان every day, every night. من صام ليلة القدر. So for you to be able to achieve this, to accomplish that task, you must begin from now to enjoy the ibadah. To enjoy the ibadah. What a lot of Muslims do, they wait until Ramadan is here and they want to sow the seed in Ramadan, they want to plant the seed in Ramadan, and they want to water the seed in Ramadan, and they want to harvest in Ramadan. Listen, you may get some fruit, but what happened to early fruits? They are what? In taste? Bitter in taste. It's not. But the fruit that takes its time, you know, you're basing yourselves, you're training, you're building up. Now you're getting used to coming to Fajr. What time Fajr comes here? Huh? Five what? I'm sure around five something, right? You're getting used to it. You're getting used to fasting now. Huh? You're getting used to Adhkar al-Sabah, Adhkar al-Masa. You're cutting down your sleep a little bit. You're already, you know, waking up. When Ramadan comes, you're going to enjoy the ibadah. It's not going to be a burden. Utilize the time, brothers and sisters in Islam, that we have to gear up for the month of Ramadan. We still have almost 20 plus days, so that, you know, we earn the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We earn the reward of forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And imagine, subhanallah, every night of the month of Ramadan, Allah could write my name and your name that we are not to go into hell at all. يَعْتِقْ رِقَابَنَا مِنَ النَّارِ. فإنشاءالله, get going, gear up, motivate yourselves, rejuvenate. You know, get in a new spirit going for this month of Ramadan. Because wallahi, quite frankly, that could be your last month. That could be my last month. ولذلك يا إخوة, they say the best way to excel in Ramadan is to treat this Ramadan as if your last Ramadan. And بنوا هذا على قياس, يعني قياس, بنوا هذا على القياس. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he stand in salah, يقول لك إيه, يعني معنى الحديث, صلوا صلاة مودع, pray as if this is your what? Your last salah. Likewise, fast this month as if your last month of Ramadan. This way you will excel, inshallah. But above all, wallahi, ya ikhwa, I want to close with that which I started with, that you avert, you protect yourselves from dua Jibreel and dua al-Nabi against you. That this dua doesn't apply to you. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving you the time to live through Ramadan, and you neglected the month. You preferred the desires, the dunya, over the task of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during this month. I want to send you home because I want to see you for Fajr, inshallah. Will you come for Fajr, inshallah? Okay, let me scan my phone. Let me just take a picture. So you're going to be for Fajr, inshallah. I'm going to have a talk with you later on, inshallah. جزاكم الله خيرا, سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك, والحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاك الله خيرا. ها؟ شكرا. Yeah, you can do it.